Hey everyone, welcome back to the workshop. This is going to be part two of the Piranha Street and Strip drag team. All right, this is we're going to build the trailer and the dragster. In part number one, we built the tow car and the diorama. So when we get all done with part two, we'll put them all together and let you see everything. Right now, we're going to work on the trailer. Let's get that out here and you can see it's literally just a one sheet instructions. Super easy, very low parts count. We'll put them out here. This would be a cool trailer for towing anything. Don't lose this little bitty here. This is your trailer hitch that just glues up underneath anything. So we're going to want to paint that the same yellow we're painting the trailer. We've got a nice steel axle. Don't lose that. We've got the trailer bed itself. Very nice looking. We've got some wheel chocks there. We've got hard plastic tires and separate wheels, which means painting after gluing will be super easy. We've got the leaf springs, we've got the dual wheel carriers, and we've got the axles and the wheel backs. So, I'm going to get this all glued together. We'll take a look. Assembly on the trailer is a whiz-bang affair. We're talking 15 minutes assembly. It's a real nice change of pace. The tires themselves, I love that they're fine that they're plastic, and I love that they're separate from the wheels. We get those nice steelies. We'll let the camera focus in on those. We got those nice steelies on there. So we get to primer these black. We get to primer the wheel chocks and leave them that way. The wheels, the trailer frame, and the hitch are going to get the exact same yellow, the exact same deep yellow as the Piranha tow car got. So I'm going to go ahead, throw some paint on these. We'll be back. It's not going to take long to put this thing together and get it all done. On the trailer, everything's out of paint and it looks fine. We got a beautiful, nice yellow paint on the trailer there. Looks great. If you're careful when you glue that metal axle in place, your wheel carriers will still flex so that no matter what angle you place the trailer at, the four tires will sit level. So we got the wheels the same yellow. What I'll do is I'll quick hand paint the springs black. The rest I'll leave all nice and yellow for the show rod. We'll put the wheels inside the tires. We'll shove those on tight. And then we got to go to the Piranha tow car and glue this hitch on at some point before we're all done. I'll also keep the wheel chocks handy. We'll find out exactly where the dragster positions on the trailer. And then we'll put those wheel chocks behind it and glue them into place in the right location. I'll get this all assembled. We'll take a quick look at it before we move on to assembling the dragster. The trailer is done. Super easy. Threw the little Piranha on there to demonstrate. The axles will rotate while the tires stay down, so no matter what you hitch it to, it'll stay in position. The tires will, once you secure it to the other vehicle. But it works just fine. It's a nice trailer. Looks great. Goes together super easy without any problems. And I like that if you're going to do hard plastic tires, I like that they mold the wheels separate and then they just press in. So we're going to keep that yellow theme up for the race team. We're going to keep working. I'm going to cut to another shot. We're going to get the parts out for the dragster. Take a look at that. Continue part two. Yes, yes, we're back to another pile of styrene. Three whole kits in one means three whole kits in one in this thing. This is all the parts for the dragster. We're going to take a look at them real quick because a lot of us have never seen these kits before. And I know you like seeing the parts on there. A huge chrome tree. Various parts of that Hemi that's going to be underneath the body. We've got the original wheels there. Another chrome tree. We've got the retooled wheels. You can see those very thin spokes. Very nice looking. We've got the underbody pan. That's going to be painted up the same yellow I've been using on everything else. We've got the huge Goodyear slicks front and rear. We've got our disc brakes there. We've got our axles and part of the drivetrain and suspension. We've got the very delicate chassis here. Very nice looking. We've got the sides of the frame of the chassis. All right. On this one here, we've got some fender parts. We've got some spoiler parts. We've got a seat. We've got chutes. That all has to be painted individually. This part here looks like a lot of fun. You actually get to make the headers for the race car. Big V8, you got eight headers sticking out. Now, one of the neatest things in here that I didn't know existed, I had no idea because I've never built this before. Let's throw it out here on the table. That's your upper body. It's clear. Yeah, it's clear. They give you one clear piece and one clear yellow piece for the rear. And for the front, they do the same. One clear piece and one clear yellow piece. That's pretty cool. I've never seen that before. Now, obviously, the idea would be here is to paint the clear piece a yellow color and match the rest of the car, or use the clear yellow piece, or however you want it. Now, what I'm going to do with this one is, because we're going with that cool yellow race team look, I'm going to leave the yellow body clear, but I'm going to use it, and I'm going to decal right over it as if it was a painted body and attach it and everything so we can still see inside and see that chassis and that big Hemi there. And the clear body is just a bonus, or you could paint over the top, or you could leave it clear when you attach it. I'm going to go with the yellow. What I'm going to do now is degrease these parts. I'm going to flat coat the chrome to give it more of a metallic magnesium aluminum raw metal look. And I'm going to future floor polish the clear parts here, so that when I use any glue on them or anything, it doesn't fix it up with smudges or scratches or anything like that. And then we'll be back to look at some of the sub-assemblies before I start throwing some color down on everything. Sub-assembly show-off is upon us. This takes, even though it's not a huge amount of parts, it takes a while. It's a lot of small, fiddly parts. There's some flash on there you want to safely cut off. And it does take a little bit. I'd say everything you see here took me about 2.5 hours to get assembled. Everything fits together nice. You just want to clean up some flash, make sure that it's going to look good when it's painted. As you can see over here, we've got multiple parts. We've got the steering column and the steering wheel. We've got the rear differential. We've got the front air duct and its air dam. We've got the umbrellas on their mount assembled. We've got the front of the roll cage. And we've got the mounts for the steering box and the front steering tie rod. Those are all going to be painted a metal color, a metallic, because obviously they're not going to take time to paint any of that stuff. That's why they're all on the same tree. This blue stuff, if you're ever wondering how I hold small parts to get as much paint on it as possible, is called Blue Tack. It's a poster putty. It's adhesive. You just mush it up, you stick it to parts, and they stick to the wall. The chrome parts here all have to be dull coated, all right? And I will be using the newer, nicer spoke wheels that they've remolded, so those are great. This is the chassis. You can see it's just absolutely fantastic, full of detail. The entire thing is going to be painted raw metal, and then I will go in and hand paint the seat and the headrest, and that's all that needs it. The rest of the vehicle would be all raw metal. They're working on it all the time. They're not going to take time. I know the instructions want me to fill in these panels with black, but they're just going to be regular sheet metal. They're going to stick it in there, especially back in the day. That's how I want it to look. Now, I don't know how the exact show car dragster looked, but I want it to look like it's all raw metal inside that it's being worked on often. So that's the cool look I want to go for it. The headers assemble individually from 6 different parts each. 4 header pipes, 1 flange to mount on the head, and then a pipe to hold them steady. So those, take your time, follow the instructions. They are labeled left and right pipes. All 8 of them are labeled 1 through 4. They'll allow you to assemble those quite easily. The Hemi is completely assembled. That's going to get painted a lighter color, like almost an aluminum color, and then painted for detail for the belt there. But the rest of it's pretty much going to maintain a raw metal look as well, with the motor mount and the join to the rear differential. The tires, of course, are going to be painted flat black, and then possibly coated with a pavement color. Brakes will be hand-painted after they've been primed. The body, lower body, and the fenders, inner fenders, will be done in the yellow you see right underneath them that's been used for everything else on this project. So, going to get all this under some paint, going to get some color on it. We'll come back and take a look. While you're looking at this, the clear yellow parts are drying with their coat of future floor polish, so in the next clip, we'll be able to take a look at that and see how much more it clears, in air quotes, clears up those parts even more, makes them look a little more glossy. So let me put my mask on, throw some paint, and we'll be back. Getting things out of paint, getting color on stuff always makes everything come to life. Now you can see the different shades of metallics that I use. There's the Hemi that will be going into the chassis, done in a raw metal, a lighter aluminum style color, and then the darker steelish color of the chassis. The color paints I used on that was a dark steel from Rust-Oleum, a metallic aluminum color from Rust-Oleum, which simulates any light metal like that, and then a nice dark yellow, caterpillar yellow, that I've used on other projects from Rust-Oleum as well for the body there, and you can see how nice that came out. Ooh, look at the shine on that, huh? So that looks really sweet. You can see that lighter aluminum color against the other parts of the chassis. Looks excellent. Dries quickly. We did the rear differential in the raw steel. So we've got some different color variations in there. What I have to do using an acrylic wash is I'll just go in and wash the sides of the roll bars on the chassis to give it a little bit of effect there and start doing some final assemblies. I have to attach the chassis inside the body frame here. It's got some nice large locators where it goes in. Then I have to glue the fenders in place and whatnot. We'll get that all in there. So I'm going to keep working on stuff. I told you I'd show you the body when I got done with that. The body has got that clear future on there and really shines that up and makes it a little more translucent. You don't see any scuffs from packaging or the molding process. They look really nice with that coat of future on it to protect it. I did it top and bottom, airbrushed it on, and then I wiped it around with a thick wet brush just to make sure it got on there in the perfect areas. So what I'll start doing now is doing a little detail painting, doing the belt on the Hemi here, doing a little shading in there to bring out some detail, and then we'll start doing some assembly. I'll be back. Before I button it all up, we'll take another look at everything and let you see how it's going. The end of the build is rushing up pretty quick. What do I have left to do? Well, I'm done with the chassis. I want you to take a look at that. When you build yours, in case you're wondering where any of the parts go, your steering linkage goes from the bottom around and into the steering plate and then to the steering wheel or steering handle as they have it in there. And then you can see how that roll cage assembles so that everything lines up and works out well. I didn't detail anything on the bottom because it sits flat in the body like that. You're never going to see it. What's the point? You can see that I did some washes on the engine just to give it some detail, not to filthy it up, just to give it some shadows and some detail. Did the same with the differential in the rear of the spool, and we did the same with the interior. Brought out the belts a little bit with a colored pencil, and then we did some washes around the side of the frame into the chassis just to give it that nice little bit of extra detail. I've got the white letters done on the tires. That was just done lightly drifting over it with a white colored pencil. We have the exhaust chutes glued into the body to keep that from clouding. I just used a clear contact cement. It's like a silicone adhesive. The front body, of course, has no work done. They say you can paint this inside, black it out for the driver, but I want to leave it clear so we can continue forever to be able to look down inside the dragster. So this is just going to go right in there in some positive locks. Then we will attach our fenders over the top like so. All right. And you can see the little unpainted area of the fender there where we had it masked will be completely hidden with the vehicle when it goes together. Then we've got to attach our air scoop, which is going to go onto the front like that. That'll be glued into place. Then there'll be another brace here. There'll be another brace here that will settle down over the pins, and that'll all line up. We'll push our wheels and tires on. We've got our headers. We got to attach our fuel tank, put that in there. And then last but not least, we will put the parachutes on, which also have been detailed with colored pencils to bring out their look to them. So when we come back, we'll be all done. I'll be decaling right over the clear body. We'll see exactly how it looks like all assembled and ready to go. So stay tuned. It's not going to take long now. Check it out. Is that not sweet or what? That clear yellow body on there really brings out a lot, you know? I love that you could still see inside. Now, I did not glue it down. You do have the option, of course, of gluing it to the lower chassis, but I wanted to leave it off so I could pop it off and look inside whenever I felt like it. The wheel chocks, the dragster is exactly as long as the trailer. So the wheel chocks actually look good on the trailer wheels themselves, just shoved into place on there. It's hitched up to the Piranha Drag Team car. When you're all done, you have a lot of decals left over. So you can go back to the drag car and you can decide what extra decals. You saw there was a lot fewer decals when I started. Now there's more to signify drag team. There's some on the hood for AMT. I put the little Piranha logos on the dragster and on the pull car. We got the hitch on there. We got the trailer. It fits on that stand so sweet. It's just absolutely fantastic. I mean, everything about this is just totally, totally cool. I've never owned this kit before. Everything goes together nicely. It's a little fiddly with the gull wing doors. It's for experienced modelers. And some of the fits on the roll body there, the roll pan, the chassis, and everything are a little tight. So you're going to want to have some modeling skills. But if you built, you know, I'd say 4 or 5 glue kits, you're going to get this one together as long as you take your time without problems. I just love that I can see the guts in there. I think it's so cool. We can do a little zoomaroonie. We'll turn it that way. We'll get you in there kind of closer so you can get a better look at that sweet dragster. It's just phenomenal. Now, if you shove the body down real tight and glue it in, then you won't have any seam in between there. You can fill that with glue and it'll seal it up. But they always had to pull the bodies off the dragsters anyways. So I don't see any issue with doing it my way whatsoever. Those new front spoke wheels look awesome. I love the cardboard diorama display. I wish something like this was in every single kit that they made. I really do. The trailer, the drag, I mean, it's just, can you tell I'm excited? I think it's so cool. This is the first full 3-in-1 big diorama display I've ever done, and I just love it, you know. Make sure you use the future on the clear body. You can also paint that body. When you're done, you'll have a bunch of waterside decals left over. You'll have the cool AMT Drag Team logo. You will also have an entire clear upper body. So if you want to change it in and out, you have enough decals to do both. You could paint this body the same yellow or whatever color you decided to paint the drag team. You could paint that a solid color. And as you can see, you still have stripes. You still have logos. You could do 2 separate bodies. You could put numbers on it. You still have more than enough stuff to decorate the kit. So this is definitely a hit. There will be a link in the description where you can get yours. Thanks for watching the workshop as always. I always love your comments, suggestions, ideas. In the comment section, like, subscribe so you never miss a model kit build, and we'll see you at the next review.